Silvers. The Honourable Prime Minister, good night. Sitting members of Parliament, members of the head table also, ladies and gentlemen. Time for mashup. Before I really get down to it, I have to tell you, there's a bomb I'm about to drop. There's a bomb I'm about to drop. When I drop this bomb, well, I know what's gonna happen. It's gonna be mashup, it's gonna be wetted, after wetted. Part one, and I'm gonna hit your part two. Part one, someone just asked me coming up here, how you end up on top of this stage? How you end up being a part of this part? Well, I really want to hear. Well, you know, I ended up with a lie from Mr. Warner and his crew. But you know why I ended up here? Let me give you a really fast story. Somebody said, but why you decide to come on the People's Partnership? Why you decide to join UNC? What's that? You sell us up? No. Wait. I said, hold up. You tell them I really ended up here, Madam Prime Minister. I'm from Port of Spain, huh? I work in Port of Spain. I decided to go down to Valise House. Because, you know, I want to get in the dance, I want to go on a platform to express your views and your voice. I went down to Valise House, and I said, good night. A short guy came out, looks like, the guy looks like Coleman Wood. I said, good night. Can I? He said, who is this? I said, Ian Allen. From where? I said, Ian Allen from Prime Watch. He said, okay, Mr. Allen. I said, can I speak to your leader? He said, hold up. I come in just now, I'm going to get my leader. I wait 5 minutes, I wait 10 minutes. Only end back and all inside. You go. No, you go now. These people don't know who's the leader. I had to walk out and say, this ain't making no sense. We got up to now. The only problem, let me tell you something, yeah? You want to vote PLM tonight? Ask them one question. Who's the leader? Who's the leader? You understand? Everybody wants to be a leader in our party. So we're going to go there. Because I told the Al Singh, cockroach have no business in foreign party, stay out. I decided now, I come back Shagunas. Listen to me, I come back Shagunas. No, my roots in Central, yeah? I'm a Shagunas boy. Family from Shagunas, I went to Village School, all kind of thing. I decided, let me go to Mulchan, Silchan Road, because they say the ILP office is there.
Ian Allen!
When I reach up, hold on, sir.
Hold on, wait.
Don't get carried away. When I reach up on the Mulchan, Silchan Road, Mulchan, Silchan Road, I saw the ILP building. But wait now, if I stand up in front of the building, I saw a big lock on the gate. But then I realized people moving around. Wait, this is ILP office, but I didn't know fraud squad move. Because I am really scared. I've seen criminal coming out. I've seen car thief coming out. I've seen deportee coming out. I make a call to Inspector Alexander. I say, come down now, we have something big here, boy. I said, come down now, we have something big here. So, I walk out. I say, well, that's it for ILP. Well, I put my tail between my legs now. I say, you know what? Let me go Kuva. Well, here now, when I reach Kuva, I'm thinking what to do. Because, you understand, these are the people that are looking for a platform to make sure they express you. I mean, the people trying to be good, you need a platform. I am your voice. Yeah. What you need, you get. You understand? Whatever you need, you get. Whatever you want, you get. I reach up. Listen, you have to listen to this. This is the important part. You can blow good, pull yourself. You can blow good. You know you can blow, pull yourself. So I realize now, listen to this, everybody in the world hear this. When I reach up in my UNC, I got my driver, I dropped in my Range Rover that I bought. I didn't keep it.
There you are,
and I sat down in the back, I put on my fancy shirt up and my suit. Now these are people, I stink up the name, yeah? I stink up Suraj, I stink up Minister, yeah? I stink up everybody. And I even about to be Prime Minister. Everybody know that? Everybody on TV, up and down, so I say, you know what? Let me test them because I come to mash them up, yeah? I say, let me see who's gonna take me in this dance now. Ladies and gentlemen, and listen to this very carefully. When I pull up by Renzi, it's Sunday, screening, I see people start a BBM, Ian Allen Reach. So I take it out, tell my driver, I say, leave. So a gentleman came and he said, come this way, Mr. Allen. You are here for screening for St. Joseph. I said, yes, yes. Yeah, now. When the man opened the door, I could see in front of me. I saw a couple of people. I saw Marlene Goodre and Ben Mehen. I saw Dr. Rudolf Mulilal. Oh God, I said, I don't know how to face this man. And my worst enemy, Rambachan, Dr. Suraj Rambachan. I speak of that man's name. I speak of that. I text the driver. I said, come back. Watch me. Come back. I say, fire it. I say, everybody hotel up your legs. I say, come back. I said, this is a bus run. I said, this is mashup. Listen to me, yeah? And listen to me carefully what I'm telling you tonight. That is how I ended up here. They did this screening, they asked me all the questions because I mashed them up. They asked me everything. Oh, you end up coming here, you like the party, you just think of the party name, all kind of thing. But remember, I am looking for a platform to express your concerns. Remember that? Ladies and gentlemen, now you need to understand, and it's something that I have never seen. When I came out of that screening committee, I jump back in my van, I go on up the road. I said they will never call me. Because I telling you, I am only human. Anytime any one of you mash me up and ask anybody about me, and they will stink up a name and fire you, you can't come back with me. I am only human. I am telling you that. Everybody have a nature. You understand? I mean, that is me. I might forgive you, but I will remember you. So I realize now, I said they will never call me. 3 o'clock in the morning. 3 o'clock in the morning, I get a call. Hello, good night. Mr. Allen, you have been selected as a candidate. Yeah. I dropped the phone. I stink up the name because remember, Sir Jackson, okay, Dr. Rambachan asked me, so Mr. Allen, what do you see the UNC? I can't watch you, man. I say, everything good, man. Good. But I'm ashamed. I say, but look at our house. They know me. Yeah. But let me tell you something. I like boxing. I tear so full, but I'm good. And let me tell you something. After that, when I appear, it's on Monday platform. On Monday platform, and let me tell you something. I say these people mad to bring me on a platform and tell me talk. Because you don't know if I come out to say full corruption, what bacchanal going on? I say these people might be planning to assassinate me. Because I'm afraid to come up now. I say, but these people tell me I get called to your speaking time for so, come out and address. But I say, I mash up these people. And let me tell you something. Nobody on this side, listen to me carefully, listen to what I'm telling. This is important, man. Not a person sitting here ever came and asked, Mr. Allen, can I see your speech? Mr. Allen, what are you saying? Are you bad talking any person here? Mr. Allen, are you going to battle the Prime Minister? Are you going to battle the Minister of Health? Hold on. Are you going to battle the AG? Ladies and gentlemen, if that is not democracy, what do you call that? Yeah. though we got a voice on, even though we got a voice on Crime Watch, we're going to the parliament now with the same voice. So I am telling you, when you vote for them, your member of parliament, and whatever you voted for, I am here and I am standing in the gap to tell you, I am going to make sure you get what you voted for. Joseph, rest assured. We started us, today I walked the area of St. Joseph. You are going to see, I couldn't believe, I hear a man called Volney Bar talking to me today. Yes. Telling people I don't have a degree, no. I want you to know, and I want to tell the Prime Minister, you need to do an investigation. Do you know Volney, I don't know who the political was. Volney got a big job at NP? Do you know this man got a big job at NP?
Yes.
Where do you think it is? The name of the company is No Place. Never before I go for that, I'll deal with him tomorrow. I have never sent my driver to collect nothing in the bomb. Let me leave that right there. Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready for the bomb?
All right.
Ready. You know, I don't know if it's possible. Yeah? I have a dream. I always wanted to do this. Yeah? Is it possible I can have maybe the Attorney General say that the speaking time for the candidate for St. Joseph be extended to 5 minutes.
Honorable Prime Minister and Chairman, I now beg to move that the speaking time for the honorable member of St. Joseph, the winning candidate for St. Joseph, Ian Allen, is extended by 5 minutes.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am sure you are aware about this Range Rover file with Anna Dilmarine. But what I'm about to tell you tonight, you know, that is not lying. No. I can't describe it. You want to hear a lie? Listen to this lie. Anna Dilmarine, the deputy leader of the ILP, our dearly beloved international luxury princess, ILP, which is a princess when princess not around, has been bad-mouthing me and the AG, desperately trying to throw her way out of this Range Rover racket with a big scandal. Listen to me carefully. The godly Miss Dilmarine has been screaming that she did not import the stolen Range Rover that she was caught driving. She said she did not import it. You all heard that? Yeah. I did not import that Range Rover. Do I have it on the screen? Director, can I get it on the screen? All right, it is on television. Director, that is what you call performance. Get my CG up. It is on television. The woman said, the deputy leader said, I never imported that vehicle. Can you hear a lie? That is a lie. After the police seized the vehicle, I never imported that vehicle. I buy it from someone. This is a statement. I buy it from someone who already owned it. That is the impression she's trying to give. But as I say, as David Rudder said, I is a man with a plan. So I really didn't waste no time. I make up my mind. This by me and his mind. You know that song?
Yes.
You know that song?
Yes.
You want to know that song?
Yes.
You want to know that song?
Yes.
This girl from Bahia. I make up my mind that Bahian girl, I'll deal with her. Ladies and gentlemen, so I started an investigation yesterday when I heard the lady protesting by this morning. I received certain information. You have to understand, I run the storm. I am the sheriff. Anything better than me, spoiler. Did not import that vehicle. Remember that, yeah? All those who are locked on all over the world, remember that she said she did not import the vehicle. It is alleged she's lying because she was the one through her company D&I Net Management Services that imported the stolen Range Rover. It's all on TV right now. I've got the name of the company. Now, as you know, I'll be in the Parliament by November the 5th. But I will send you the follow-up. After cool my hopes a little bit, so I want to be here then. Please look at the documents. All those who are online, wherever you are, ladies and gentlemen, I have in my possession here an application for the license to import goods to Trinidad and Tobago on the 22nd of January 2009. One diesel Range Rover used with AC, blah, blah, blah. Hold on. This is the application form. Application that she made with her company. She's the corporate secretary of the company. Oh, you can come and lie and say you didn't import the goods here. You can lie. Oh my God. All of these. They belong to a club of liars. Liars and liars. I tell you, Om Lala has his hands full. Because if he is a criminal lawyer, even though he would lose, he will still get work because he doesn't represent all of them. I have, in my possession here, an import license. The import license is 0093961 to D&I Management Services, 91 Bucal Road, Kulopia. Anna, where's that one, your brother? Sister, where's that one? Where's that one? You're lying, you come on, you're lying, but don't worry. Pull up. She do so after now. Look at ball, yeah? I tell you, that is why. They kick out that one from FIFA because he know ball, but tell him I say, I am the goalkeeper here, you can't kick nothing. I got my captain sitting on here. Hear what she did? I'm passing this to all about. I am going to give you a copy of the application just now. You're going to have it. You're begging me that all of them work. And I have something a little bit wrong. Wait. If you're a journalist, I have in my back pocket. You know that people say, the bio journalists and ministers bio journalists. I have a list in front of me here with names of journalists. I believe their salary should be raised. I'm not fighting for you to dodge here. But listen to me. This is what she said. To whom it may concern, I am the holder of the license to import and use right-hand drive 2006 Range Rover diesel engine. My import license number is 009361. And she said she did not import it and she buy it from a man. Why am I lying so far here? I will need to amend the license as follows. Year of manufacture needs to be changed from 2006 to 2008. You see, Paul? You see, Paul, and you want to tell me I am the clown? You're a big crook. The cost of the vehicle needs to be changed from 160,000 to 224,000. Watch, Paul. Shipper's name from Anand Service. She ended up, ladies and gentlemen, getting the approval and whatnot. But I want to know how you will answer this. So ladies and gentlemen, tonight, that is what you call mashup. So when you lie and say you're never important, I am going to give the crowd a copy of the license under the DNA. Take it and distribute it to the people. Come with this. Distribute, I have over 1,000 copies here. Give it to the media, give it to everybody. Because when you come and you mash up with people here, I am the goalkeeper here. Watch how you flex when you flex. Good night.